slowly cutting. Okay, I'm going to stop it. I'm going to adjust it out. Oh, wrong way. I'm going to adjust it out 10 thousandths. Turn it on. The whole meal table shakes when it starts to engage.
Yep.
Slowly cutting. A little bit more. Video and I'll come back when I check the hole for the make sure the hole is the proper size. I'll come back a little bit later. Honestly, close to what I think is our final size. I'm going to run the cutter in because right now it's inside the lube grooves. You know, if this was a straight wall bullet where we had like a silhouette type of patched bullet, we could easily make a cutter that was a straight wall cutter and wouldn't interfere with anything. But we've got to run it in and out of the lube grooves. I'm running it in as far as I can. I'm going to turn on my digital readout up top so that I don't take and I want to get it back exactly where we started at. Okay, now I can see inside the hole and see where the base of the bullet's going to be. I'm going to use my expanding T gauge to measure that. Would take several measurements. Lock that in there and bring it out. And our first measurement is 438. Let's check that again. I'm trying to get this. In there where it's not interfering with anything. All right, that's a snug fit. Now let's check it again. 440 that way. What was it the first time?
438, I believe.
Well, it leads me to believe we're only at 438. 438, 440.
Still away.
I'm guessing we're at 440. So what we'll do is plunge the cutter back in. I'm going to put the cutter back in exactly where it came from. My DRO is telling me we're at, and I can feel pressure from the bottom of the mold, and I'm going to stop right there, lock it down. My DRO says we need to go 2/1000ths of an inch deeper, but I believe it's wrong. Now I will run the cutter out back where we were just at. And we'll continue cutting. All right. Right there. Just run it out. Let's see, make sure we got it out all the way. All right, now we fill the hole with cutting fluid again. All right, and turn it on. Now we keep cutting. And we'll check it again later and see where we're at. I'll film it, I'll continue to film a little bit later on, but you guys can see exactly what I'm doing. And when you put your, let me stop just a minute to tell you one thing. I have found that if you fill this cavity up completely with cutting fluid, it helps all your waste metal come out, because you're not going to keep pulling the bit out like you would drilling a hole, and it doesn't have flutes to help guide the metal out. The cutting fluid helps them float out, so just keep the hole full of cutting fluid. Back in, run the cutter so that it's clearing the lube grooves. I'm going to run it up. I'm going to check our diameter. And I'll tell you something, if we don't get the diameter on the nose of the bullet that we do at the base, let's say the nose of the cutter just isn't cutting right, what we can do is make a little lap, a little flap. It's a little piece of rod that's slit on end. We'll put sandpaper on it and lap out the nose of the bullet, make the nose of the bullet a little bit wider. Let's see what our diameter is now. I really don't want to get it any larger than 470. I need a stronger spring in the end of my tool to push these poppets out a little bit. 449, there's no way that didn't cut enough.
Very tedious process.
Yeah, because we didn't film up, but we just stopped and checked it. .453. Well, I'll pause it again the next time I take the cutter out and we measure. All right, now that we've been out here, I think we've been out here, what, 5 hours now?
Yeah.
It has taken longer than I expected. The last time we measured it, it was 466. We're shooting for 468 or maybe 470, you know, if we got a sizer and sized it down. I'm turning the cutter in so that it disengages from the lube grooves. I don't want to pull it straight out and wipe out my a small segment of the lube grooves. Although that may have happened anyway. Okay, unlock the spindle. Bring it up. Okay, I'm going to take a piece of paper towel and clean out the cavity and the mold. And now I'll use an expanding T-gauge to measure. As long as the base of the bullet mold is perfect, I can lap out the nose if the cutter didn't get the nose perfect. I know the first mold I made, it didn't make it perfect, and I lapped it out a little bit. 467.